Mark Unley, I know how hard this must be to do, but we really appreciate your time. And I guess the only thing you can do at the moment is make more public pleas.
That's, you know, pretty much the only tool we have to be able to make a change here to this policy and these rejections. So we are not giving up, not for a minute, not for a second. Important. And it's not just personal. It's not just our plight. This has happened to many other people. We've heard horror stories. And from all the support we've had from the Australian people, from the media like yourselves and everybody, we just feel like this is a fight that needs to be fought. This is, after all, a democracy, and compassion has to be a part of that democracy.
Indeed, especially more than a year into a pandemic. And sadly, you're not the only one in this situation, but you have a letter from the US consulate. You've offered to wear a hazmat suit. You've made another plea. What was the response?
We got the response on Saturday morning. It was once again rejected, once again for the same reasons that we pose a high risk to the health of the people of Queensland.
Right. So the offers of doing what you can, even though the US consulate says you've vaccinated, you've taken all the precautions, I imagine you've tested negative to your latest COVID test?
That's correct. And that would mark the third test we've had since this whole deal began, the third negative test.
And Mark, how are you communicating with your dad at the moment?
Through FaceTime. We actually just spoke to him. Sometimes he's not able to talk to us. Sometimes he's too weak. And other times he's able to. And other times if my dad's carer is there or my brother and their family are there, they can assist with that. So we are able to be in touch with him, which is thank heavens for that. But of course, we'd rather be there holding his hand.
Indeed. And you sound like you're in the best spirits that you possibly could be in this awful circumstance. If you don't get an early exemption, when are you due to get out of hotel quarantine anyway?
The 29th.
It's 8 days from now.
8 days from now, so next Tuesday.
And how's your dad? Do you think that you might be able to see him, even if it is in 8 days' time?
You know, it's. I think anyone who's experienced this kind of end of life situation knows that it's such an up and down thing. You know, it just depends on the day. When we arrived here on Tuesday, and we gave him the terrible news that we'd been rejected and we wouldn't be on the plane that he was expecting, he just sort of lost hope, and that resulted in him being rushed to the hospital later that day. And then again, on Saturday morning, when we told him about the latest rejection, once again, his condition just took a nosedive and we weren't able to talk to him the rest of the day. He was just incredibly weak. It just depends on the day. I mean, you know, that would be obviously what we all want. But every single day that we're sitting in here is a day that they are stealing away from us and our family to be able to just be together and say goodbye in dignity and in humanity.
Well, Mark Unley, I'm so sorry we're so helpless in this situation, but once again, thanks for talking to us, and we just hope someone changes their mind for the sake of you and your family.
Thank you very much. You. And we are up at 35,000 signatures on change.org/
Say goodbye.
So if that's a great way for people to support us, and we really appreciate all you guys are doing. Thank you.
Okay, that's great. Thanks so much. Appreciate it. We've got our fingers crossed for you.